Jackie Joyner-Kersee solidified her place as the world's best female athlete.
Jackie Joyner-Kersee is the greatest female athlete who has ever lived.
We're standing right here with the world's greatest female.
The reigning queen of track and field.
The greatest female athlete in the world.
The opening of the heptathlon and the favorite Jackie Joyner-Kersee. Like
lifetime best, gold medal. Possibly the greatest that we have ever seen.
Bobby Kersee, husband and coach.
He does celebrate, doesn't he?
And over easily on her first attempt.
Jackie Joyner-Kersee comes to the finish line well in front.
I just kept saying to myself, come on, Jackie. You got to run this curve. You got to run it.
Nobody had ever successfully defended a gold medal in the heptathlon until now.
And Olympic champion to that jacket, another world record. Come on.
She is the toughest lady I have ever seen. There's just no give in Jackie Joyner-Kersee.
Attack the board. You got to attack the board.
Another Olympic record for Jackie Joyner-Kersee, and Bobby's knocked out over it.
She has the heart of a champion, doesn't she, Dwight? Jackie Joyner-Kersee is the first lady of track and field.
Hi, I'm excited to help kick off the World Federation of Youth Club International Conference. I'm Jackie Joyner-Kersee. How I started the Jackie Joyner-Kersee Community Center, and it started when I was a very young girl. I came through a community center. I worked with volunteers. I didn't really know what a volunteer did at that time because I was 9 years of age, and that set my mind on how important it was to have adults in your life who was guiding you, helping you, and so it wasn't until I was 18. I go off to school. Unfortunately, I lose my mother and I come back home and I wanted to go somewhere where I knew that my spirit could be uplifted. And I thought I would go over to that center. Little did I know that that community center was shut down. And so I just started thinking at the age of 18, where do the young people go and how I could open up, reopen that center, and not knowing that really was challenging. And so it wasn't until years later, I opened the Jackie Joyner-Kersee Center. But before I had a center, I felt that I didn't need a building to help people. So I took some of my sponsorship dollars from my track and field sponsorships, put it into my church, into youth programs, into my high school, middle school, as well as elementary school, people who had really poured into me. And eventually it came to a time where I was approached about trying to open up a community center. And we broke ground on the Jackie Joyner-Kersee Center in 1996, and we opened in 2000. And in 2000, that was the beginning of us. At one point we were doing Boys and Girls Club programming, but I really believe in working with the total family. And so now we just have the Jackie Joyner-Kersee Center. We do transportation. We pick our students up from school, bring them to the JJK. We use sports as a hook, and they go through our JJK winning life curriculum based around 14 different principles. We warm meals, we feed them. They get the education tutorial help. We have greenhouse, agriculture. It's a lot that we're doing, and it's because of just coming through a community center when I was younger. The reason I decided to come back home, and for those of you who are not familiar, I went to school at UCLA. And I went out there for a purpose, and that purpose was to graduate from college. And if I could make an Olympic team, make an Olympic team. But as I was growing up, you always heard nothing good come from your community. But I knew there were a lot of great people in the community trying to do great things. And a lot of times you don't read about them in the newspaper, or you don't see them on television, but they are the people, boots on the ground. that's really trying to make a difference. And for me, I just had this dream of really just wanting to make my parents proud. And if I could go to the Olympics, yes, I wanted to be on television, but I didn't know all that was going to come, you know, come to pass, but it did. And so as I evolved and as I grew, I always said I'll never forget where I had come from. And that's why it was important for me to go back in the community so our young people can have a conversation with me, they could touch me, and they know that it's possible. Because I might not walk in their same shoes they walk in, but I do walk the same streets. And we can meet each other, you know, meet them where they are, but then also try to pour into them and give them the inspiration to believe the impossible is probable. So that's why it was very important for me to come back into the community. Yeah, being able to build a community center, you know, in an area where, you know, where it's distressed and, you know, there's a lot of challenges. But one thing about having the community center is that you see growth around it. You know, not only just having a building, but the young people who have come through the doors and who have gone on and have been successful. And not everyone is successful, but they have learned something from being involved with our staff here at the JJK Center and trying to better their lives and also trying to, you know, reach their full potential. So one thing about it is that even with the people out there that's going to be working, that's a part of this conference, is that you're going to work with people. And a lot of times, it is very challenging. But just know that the seed that you plant and you nurture that seed, you invest in these young people's lives and you're going to see a return on that investment. So it's the investment part of it, but more important, you must have a vested interest in that person. And then that's when you will see the return on the investment. And that's what I see when our young people come back from college, they come back and they mentor, they come back and share what they've learned. They also talk about their challenges and also be thankful to the staff, because now they see someone that might look like them. And they were like, I remember when I wouldn't stop talking, I wouldn't do this. And now I understand. So it's great. The one thing I could say, growing up and coming through a community center, and you don't know where your life is going to take you, but there are always mentors, you know, coaches, you know, people that you might look up to. And so for me at the community center, one of the guys was like, I would beat the workers there, you know, they were like, well, we're going to give you a job. Knowing I wasn't old enough to have the job, but my job was to put out the ping pong paddles, you know, to make sure the balls were all, you know, just all kind of different things. And it wasn't until I met one of the executive directors who introduced me to Coach Nino Fanon. That's how I got into track and field. And so, but they were always giving of encouragement. You know, it wasn't what we couldn't do. They were always telling us what we could do. And I always told us you had to be willing to work hard. And so being in that type of environment, and for everyone that's out there, is that you are a connector. You make a difference in the lives of the people you come across, and just having a positive conversation with them. Because remember, you are the messenger and they're going to listen to your message, and you can change their course of life by just being a positive and being authentic and being real with them as well. My advice, one, would be never give up, but just know in youth development, you know, when you're working with young people, that you have to have a lot of patience, you know, a lot of understanding. Also understanding your why for why you're doing this. And And then know that if you're trying to build a community center, that it takes resources to take a great board. You got to make sure that you stand on top of everything and find out what works best for the area that you're in. Is that meet your community, meet your young people where they are, but then just know that it's going to take everyone, you know, business-minded people, community people, you know, people that believe in your vision, believe in your dream, believe in your mission to see it through. And even when you go through a rough patch, you know, because we all do, you know, and the biggest thing about nonprofit is raising funds. And because there are so many entities that people can fund, is that find your niche and stay true to your dream, your mission, and your vision. And find people that believe in your mission and your vision to help you get to the next level. I just want to say thanks for having me, and I want to wish you the very best at your conference. And remember, those who know why will always be those who know how. Thank you.